Hello Gundam fans, this is Bandai2, and today I'll be looking at the 1/100 Master Grade Ground Gundam from the Mobile team, and I got the model kit from Canadian Gundam. Link is in the description below. So, there have been other variants of the, like using a lot of these parts, and the inner frame, you got the Ground GM, you got the EZ-8, which were all released around the same time. It is an older kit, an older Master Grade. It does use screws in the elbows and the shoulders. I think that was it. So not a lot of screws, really. Older ones, like even older ones, would use it in the knees and the elbows and the shoulders, and I think sometimes the waist. So only a few here. My only complaint with the assembly is that arm, and I don't know why, because this one seems to be fine, but this one does not go in flush, and when I rotate it, see, you got this weird gap. It's like bending, and I don't know why. Maybe the mold for the peg is a little off-center. But that's really my only complaint. It's still a good, decent build. A lot of nice detail. You only have the forehead camera, the eyes, back of the head camera, foil stickers. And then you have the rub transfer sheet and the marking stickers, if you want to use them. And the opening cockpit. Very easy to work. You got the pilot in there. And you do have the figure, which is a little gummy looking, not very detailed, kind of flat, but this is an older one, so it makes sense. And I don't know what this thing is. It opens up. I can't remember what that's for. But it only does it on the one side. Not a big deal, but whatever. So yeah, it's a nice chunky boy. But they are chunky in general, so I don't have a problem with that. Yeah, it's going to be nice next to the Ground GM and the EZ-8. So the head is ball-jointed. The arms are ball-jointed. And they're also hinged, so they don't go out that far. That's it. Rotate below the shoulder. You do have a double-jointed elbow, which is nice and tight because of the screw. You got a ball-jointed wrist with the ball-jointed thumb. The old fingers with the index finger and the three fingers together, and they're all hinged. You got the nice ball-jointed waist. Ball-jointed front skirts. Hinged side skirt. The legs can hinge forward and back separately, which is rare, I'd say. In an older kit. They can go forward, not much back, not much out, a little bit of give in the ball joint. You do have a double jointed knee, but the top joint just does that. So it's mostly the bottom hinge. And then the ankle, it does have a piston. The pistons are really, really tight, like going into the top part. They're very tight. So it's a good, nothing's broken. But they're just really tight, so it doesn't have loose beat. They can go forward and back, side to side. Just a little, hardly any rotation, really. Ankle armor is hinged, and that's about it. So, it is definitely hindered articulation, with the hips not going up very far, and the ankles are kind of limited. Yeah, it's older articulation, but you can still get some toes. These suits are not, they're just basically walking tanks in the show, in the OVA. So you get what you need, really. So besides the articulate hands, you have a pair of open hands and a pair of closed fists, if you want to use them. And then you have the shield, which has the connector here, which is on a double hinge, and I pushed a little too hard when I was putting it in here and stressed this little clip, which I never used, but it is there. So I would suggest you put it onto the arm away from the actual shield so you don't accidentally bend that clip thing and then push it in. And we also have the beam saber handles in the calves. Just gotta hinge it out, thumbs right out, and you do have a pair of clear pink beams. It'll hold the beam sabers well enough. It is a little loose, but because the hilt is a little thicker, it won't slide up unless you do that. Well, why would you do that? I don't know. And I do find it's a little tricky to get it into the back into the cavity. You know, like the first time, after that, it's a little easier. You got to like push down hard to get it all the way down, so that the cover can clear. And then you have the machine gun, which has movable stock. You got a movable extra handle. You do have the ability to change the ammo with the side skirts, which are all the same. They just slide right in, stay in place very well. And because these are the older style hands, you can't really get a great grip on the weapons. They usually, if, and this is perfect, they always want to droop. Like, if you get it like that, it's pretty good. It's not too, it's kind of angled. See, it doesn't take much to make a move. And then we have the beam rifle, which has a movable handle and a sticker for the sensor. And it's pretty much the same thing. Just because of these older hands. It's all really about the thumb and where you place it to get the weapons to actually stay well. And then the main attraction is the backpack with the stored, 180 millimeter cannon, I think? I really love this weapon in Battle Operation 2. So you want to pull this out some, so you have the space to pull this down, and then this is supposed to be here. That's where it's stored. And then this whole tray can slide out on a track. It should anyways. Slide right out. And we'll just put this on the backpack. So I do like how it collapses here when it's not anything on it. And then you have this part which can extend. And then these parts can extend. I suggest holding them both and pulling up, because they are kind of connected. And then you just have to, there's the holes here, there's some tabs in the back, line them up, and then push the bottom part up a little bit, just what kind of, well, usually grabs on good enough, but yeah, it'll hold, it'll be fine. Not really back heavy even with the weapons in, because these are pretty light, these parts. So let's make the cannon. I find these barrels stay in well, but these parts don't really hold the best in here. So once you open the backpack, they'll probably fall. But anyways, you got these parts. They're just gonna slide together. And then you got the handle there. And you got this part, which is gonna go in here. And this part is actually keyed in. There's a little tab there. I'm gonna line it up. And there's the can. So you can have it held with this handle here. Maybe you want to have it over the shoulder like that for some reason. Or you can have it like that. Now, also, you can take the shield, and they give you this extra piece. So this thing will clip onto the little round part on the shield, and then this part will clip onto the barrel of the cannon. So this way you get the ground Gundam in a pose kneeling down, and this would be like support, which I can't remember if the EZ8 has this too. Probably does, I just forgotten. But I do appreciate that. It just makes it a little more secure when you're posing it. Because unlike the, I think it's the high grade. The newer one has the flip out piece here, so it can actually stay by itself. Nobody would do that in this master grade, so I do appreciate this little clip. And those are the accessories, so it definitely has a lot. And they all, like, because of the old style hands, it's not going to be perfect. When you put them in the hand, you can fiddle with it, and it'll look okay. But don't be surprised if you come in and look at the shelf one day, and like the weapons are laying on the ground. Just the way it is. But I do like the accessories. So I think we'll start with the RX-78-2 version Gatoki, since it is also an older Master Grade around the same time, I'd say. The Ground Gundam might be a little newer. I'm not 100%. I think it might have come out afterwards. And then we'll do the GM Ground type. You see, there are a lot of new pieces on it, like compared to the GM. But there are a lot of pieces that are definitely reused. And then finally, the EZ-8, which, of course, because it was a ground Gundam, and it took a lot of damage, so they repaired it, and it changed quite a lot. So that is the Master Grade Ground Gundam. I really do like it, even though it is an older kit. It was a fun build. Well, like I said, my only problem is that one arm, I think the peg might be warped or something. But it stands fine, got that big backpack, still fine. All the weapons are neat, and just have to fiddle with them in the hand. But that's just the way it is with the older style Master Grade hands. So if you want to pick it up, click the link below to go to Canadian Gundam, and I'll see you in the next review.